discouraged. Oh, I realize it's hard to take courage.
The Penn State Board of Trustees tonight decided that it is in the best interests of the university to have a change in leadership to deal with the difficult issues that we are facing. In addition, Joe Paterno is no longer the head football coach, effective immediately.
Don't be unhappy, can't remember when last saw you laughing. This world makes you crazy, and you've taken all you can bear. Just call me up, 'cause I will always be there. And I see your true color shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you.
Who I love.
You guys are great, all of you. When I say guys, you know what I mean. You know what I mean, girls too. All right, hey, look, get a good night's sleep. All right, study. All right, we still got things to do. All right, I'm out of it maybe now. A phone call put me out of it, but we'll go from here, okay? Hey, good luck, everybody. Hey, thanks for coming.
I see your true color shining. That's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors.
True colors are beautiful,
like a rainbow.
Wanna tell you, you're all gonna be called upon to help. This is everybody's fight. Not just a few people's fight. And they want us to go away. They really do think we're going to go away. Like hell we will.
This is an opinion piece. The views expressed in this podcast are those of just Franco Harris. Things didn't end the way we had expected for Joe Paterno. But then again, the story isn't over. How many people could have stood the test of time for over 60 years? Someone who stood for integrity, honesty, and loyalty to the end. That someone would shape the character of so many young men. That someone is Joe Paterno. And he is that someone who stands for integrity, honesty, and loyalty. And he is the greatest college coach in history. Joe Paterno stood the test of time for over 60 years, generation after generation. And as I said, things didn't end the way we had expected for Joe Paterno. But then again, the story isn't over. This is about our quest for the truth for Joe. So let's take a closer look at how the Sandusky shower incident at Penn State, when there was no sexual abuse, became one of the biggest child sex abuse cases of all time. And how did Penn State become the main focus of the Sandusky alleged abuse case? And how did Joe Paterno become the face of the Sandusky alleged abuse case? This podcast is about the presentment of lies. This presentment of lies was detailing, or should I say lying, about the Jerry Sandusky shower incident in the football facility at Penn State University. At that time, the leak of the presentment of lies was all the news, and it turned into big news, national news. But you will see why we are calling this 33rd statewide investigating grand jury presentment on finding the facts for victim two, the presentment of lies. A lie is always a lie. It never becomes the truth. Even time can't turn a lie into the truth. So this is about the lifelong integrity of a good man and a great coach, Joe Paterno, and his Penn State football teams. They deserve the truth. So I guess I'm saying that finding the truth is a form of justice, especially when the other parts of our justice system have failed. No doubt, to find the truth takes time, and we have been doing this for years. I know a lot of people are probably tired of hearing about this, but just because people are tired of hearing about it doesn't mean it's no longer important. And with this being about Joe Paterno, Tim Curley, Gary Schultz, and Graham Spanier, there is not a better group of guys to fight for, to find the truth for. When you remember back then, after the leak, everything was happening so fast. Fast allegations with no proof, of course. Fast lies with no checks. But people wanted more and more, faster and faster. But when John Sermon got the easily led Penn State Board of Trustees to fire Joe Paterno, then the story changed from Jerry Sandusky to Joe Paterno. Now it was all about Joe. This was given round-the-clock attention. Talk radio discussions were intense. Social media, every form of media was involved. And the main focus was Joe Paterno. It kept getting bigger and bigger and louder and louder. The many people who knew Joe were struggling to understand everything. I mean, what was happening? How could this be happening to Joe? His lifelong integrity was being attacked, even by our own Penn State Board of Trustees and the new Penn State administration. The lies of Joe Paterno, Tim Curley, Gary Schultz, Graham Spanier, and their families were being torn apart. Our own Penn State Board of Trustees did not support or protect our own Penn State people. Think about it. John Surma removed the people who cared deeply for Penn State and who had the most heart for Penn State. They removed the people who would have stood up and fought for Penn State. I'm talking about Joe, Tim, Gary, and Graham. They were the fighters that were removed. And you saw what was left. And we all saw what happened. And as I said, we were struggling to understand what was happening. We knew these men, good men. And what was happening didn't make sense. No way would any of them, Joe Paterno, Tim Curley, Gary Schultz, or Graham Spanier, ever, never turn their backs on a child being abused. So what was going on? Turns out, there was a lot going on. There are so many facets to this story, and so many subplots that it's difficult to give you the facts as we now know them in any straightforward manner. I hope you'll stay with me as we try to unravel them.